But when you do the problem solving, there is a 5-why methodology that is really saying that you should ask 5 whys until you are no longer able to logically answer it. So 5 is a symbolic number. Sometimes it's 6, sometimes it's 4. But you ask whys as many times as necessary until you cannot logically answer the why anymore. But from the supplier's point of view, it is very important that why we made these bad parts. From the customer's point of view, the first important thing is why did you ship it? Assuming that you had a problem within your process, which is not abnormal for most processes, but why did you not catch it and why did you ship it? But first we address why made. 5-why principle is done for why made. So the first thing is high installation panels were found at the customer. Why? One clip wouldn't line up. Why? Door panel was deformed in the doghouse area. Why? Weight of the door panel was concentrated on the doghouse when being painted in the oven. Why? Because a new rack design was inadequate. Why? Inadequate confirmation to authorize the use of the new racks. Why? PCR, process change request procedure, was not used. Why? CPM, or change point management importance, was not understood. So really we used 7 whys in this particular situation, but we went and we didn't go any further why CPM was not, CPM's importance was not understood. It doesn't really lead to any significant information. So this is why you stop at the 7th why in this particular situation, but it's called 5 whys as a symbolic number. Then the second part is why shipped, assuming, that's what the customer says, assuming you had made some defective parts. I can understand that you changed the racks and you didn't pay attention. That's not okay, but fine, I understand that. Why did you ship it? So why shipped methodology when it comes to 5 whys? It goes as follows. High installation effort panels were shipped to the customer. Why number one? Why? QC technician considered the parts as good. Why? Tech was only supposed to check the profile and the dimension, not the installation effort. Why? It wasn't included in the SWS, this standardized worksheet. Why wasn't it included? Because bad or incomplete design of the check-in fixture. Okay, so if the check-in fixture was designed bad, the solution is have the installation robot check as the Pokayoke or aeroproofing in order to make sure that the check-in fixture is complemented now. Now we found out that the check-in fixture design was inadequate. One approach is to fix the check-in fixture design, which may take up to many weeks because they're very complicated pieces of fixtures. Or the other thing was that give the check-in fixture responsibility to the robot which assembles these retainers and let the robots work as the Pokayoke aeroproofing device. And that's what we did, which was a lot faster and more accurate and more consistent, by the way. So here it goes. So we assume that these are the main causes and these were the countermeasures. And we assigned these people to implement it and these people to confirm it, as you see over here. Joe was supposed to do it and Yumi QCE was supposed to confirm that it was done. And these are the deadlines between January 13 and January 21st. We were supposed to change the design of all the racks, matter of 8 days. We replaced all the racks and modified the design so they will accommodate the new requirement by the customer. And by January 21st, the QCE at the customer was able to confirm that it was done correctly. This is how the new paint racks were fixed, so they don't warp the retainer doghouse. And this is where the assembly robot would check as a Pokayoke or error-proofing device to make sure that the doghouses were not deformed. And this is a picture of the change point management cards that you see that we used when we implemented this. And of course, all the green circles on the right-hand side of the slide mentioned that they were complete, satisfactorily complete, so all circles were filled with green color. Then you check the effectiveness of your solution, of your countermeasure. As you see over here, the deformed doghouse found a new me right after the date that we had the report for 35 pieces. After we implemented these countermeasures, it went down to zero state, zero for the duration of this problem solving, which was all the way to a month later. However, 13 months later, we still had no defect regarding this problem or any other problem shipped to our customer. And the deformed doghouse made, it went down. It didn't go down to zero immediately because it took us 8 days to modify the door racks, the hanging racks, if you remember. So from 252 on one day that we made, it went to 210, it went to 105, until all the door racks were fixed on January 21st. If I remember correctly, it went down to zero and then stayed at zero. And zero warped doghouses made after January 21st. And goal was achieved. So first, no more deformed doghouses were shipped to the customer within 4 hours, less than a shift. We were able to control everything that we were shipping to the customer. First root cause, the second thing, root cause was identified. 13 new racks were designed, tested, and manufactured in 8 days. I remember during those 8 days, we were working night and day to make sure the customer was protected and dazzled. That was because of one of the things that we believed in. We worked during the weekend, night and day, to fix this and manufacture the racks and etc. And every part was reworked prior to shipment to make sure that the customer was protected.